Obviously, we're still in the throes of a pandemic here. Omicron cases are surging across the country. And so it's going to be, I'm sure, an important emphasis for you guys to make sure that everything's up to snuff with protocols. Could you just touch on what you guys are doing to make sure that this weekend doesn't end up becoming a super spreader event in Colorado's high country?
Yeah, absolutely. Look, I mean, the fact that we proceeded with this last year when really nobody was doing any kind of events anywhere was a calculated risk because failure wasn't an option, right? Our goal as a company was to get open and stay open all season long. And we were able to do that. So we've got a good template from last year. What we're doing specifically this year, any of those viewing zones close up to the courses or like the festival village, as they call it, you're going to have to prove vax to get in those areas. Kids 12 and under are going to have to wear a mask and be accompanied by a vaccinated adult. But we were pretty tight last year, and knock on wood, we were successful. I think this year's set up to be as successful as we can. Look, we're clearly aware of what's going on the world around us. So we're working with our partners in the community to try and ensure that this is as safe an event as can be. It is outdoors. There's plenty of space. So I think that we've got a good plan. But again, if we've learned anything in the last year and a half, it's that it's the need to adapt. So we'll adapt on the fly. It's 3 days, so it's going to be quick.